Morning students, today we will discuss about biology, class 10, chapter 1, life processes. So before studying that chapter, we will discuss few things about the living beings. So what are the characteristics of the living beings? So they can move, they can respire, they intake of food, they excrete, they transport of food, they reproduce. Okay students, these are a few characteristics which we often observe about the living beings when we differentiate it from the non-living beings. Now come on the main topic, which is life processes. So what are the life processes? These are the life processes which organism perform to sustain their life on the earth. So like what are life processes? Life processes are the main processes performed by living beings to sustain their life on this earth. So that are the movement, living beings show movement. Okay, so living beings respire, means they do breakdown of food. Next is nutrition, or nutrition is the intake of food. Next is excretion, removal of the or get rid of the waste material from their body. Next is the transportation, the food absorbed by their body and transport to different parts of their body. Next is reproduce, or reproduction, the method of giving birth to their young ones, that is reproduction. So next we will discuss about the nutrition in plants, or nutrition in organisms. So first of all, what is nutrition? Nutrition is a process of intake of nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, minerals, vitamins and water by the organism, as well as their utilization in their body. Next we will discuss about the what are the modes of nutrition. That is, first is autotrophic, second is the heterotrophic, in the autotrophic mode of nutrition, what happens there? In the case of autotrophic nutrition, the mode of nutrition in which the organism make their own food from simple inorganic material like carbon dioxide, water, in the presence which is present in their surrounding, and with the help of sunlight. And examples of autotrophic nutrition are plants and few bacteria. Okay, second one is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition is that nutrition in which the organism cannot make their own food from a simple inorganic material like carbon dioxide, water, and depend upon the other for their food. Examples of their fungi, animals, okay, even human beings. Next we will discuss about the type of heterotrophic nutrition. There are three types of heterotrophic nutrition. First one is saprophytic. Second one is parasitic. Third one is holozoic. Holozoic mode of nutrition. First, saprophytic nutrition. Saprotrophic word is here. Sapro word is related to dead decaying matter. So the mode of nutrition in which the organism obtain their food from the dead decaying material like dead plant, body, dead animals, rotten rats, that is a saprotrophic or saprophytic mode of nutrition. Example of that is fungi. Second is parasitic mode of nutrition. In the parasitic mode of nutrition is that nutrition in which the organism drive its food from the body of another living organisms without killing it. Example of the parasitic mode of nutrition is cascata. Cascata plant, Plasmodium, Protozoa. Third is holozoic mode of nutrition. In the holozoic mode of nutrition, the organism take the complex organic food material into their body by process of ingestion, and ingested food is digested and then absorbed into the body cells of the organism. Examples, every animal, all the animals are holozoic. So example is animals. Even human being also included under the animals. So it's also example of holozoic mode of nutrition. Next students, we will discuss about nutrition in plants. So what is the mode of nutrition in plant? We have already discussed that is autotrophic mode of nutrition in plant, and which process they perform in the autotrophic process, that is photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is related to photo, related to light, and synthesis is related to make food. Okay, beta. So in that case, what happens in photosynthesis? In photosynthesis, the process by which green plant make their own food from carbon dioxide, water, by using sun energy in the presence of chlorophyll is called photosynthesis. So in a reaction form, I will discuss here what happened during photosynthesis. 6 molecule of carbon dioxide plus 6 molecule of water plus light energy in the presence of chlorophyll, they make glucose, complex molecule glucose, C6H12O6 plus 6 molecule of water is released here. Okay beta, now we will discuss ki what are the main steps here in which the photosynthesis occurs. First step is the absorption of the light energy by the chlorophyll which is present in the green leaves of the plant. Second is breakdown of water into hydrogen and oxygen. Third process is reduction of carbon dioxide. By the reduction with the of the carbon dioxide, hydrogen is added to the carbon dioxide and form a glucose molecule, or we can say carbohydrates. Next we will discuss about the what are the essential conditions necessary for photosynthesis. So first one is chlorophyll. Second one is light. Third one is CO2. Fourth one is water. Now one by one we will discuss how these necessary things plant get from their surrounding. Water is taken up by the plant from the soil with the help of their roots. Carbon dioxide is obtained by the plant from the surrounding air with the help of tiny pores present in their leaves called stomatas. Light energy directly from the sun, and chlorophyll is already present in their chloroplast in their leaves. Okay students, so this all things about the plant nutrition. In next session we will discuss about the animal nutrition.